What is up, my friends? Stacker Sargentius coming back at you. You know, there's a lot of people that are ignorant to silver and gold and precious metals in general, their important role they've played in history, the important role they still play in economics, no matter what some people say. And there's just a lot that people don't know. And I find that just, like, people just don't really care. And that's just fine. But those people are ignorant. Ignorant doesn't mean not knowing stuff. Ignorant means you have the capacity to know stuff and you choose not to. Which varies very drastically from the idea of nescience. Nescience is also not knowing things. That's what nescience means. But nescience means that you do not have the capacity to know something. A baby is not ignorant. A baby is nescient. The baby doesn't know things, and so does society. Baby doesn't know about precious metals. Society doesn't know about precious metals. Society is ignorant. The baby is nescient. So that's basically the two different types of not knowing things. Let's try to know things. Not too long ago, I was ignorant about precious metals, and I would often get the same kind of ideas in my mind. I've noticed that there's a lot of people that whenever they think about precious metals, they think about coins, or they think about spot price, or bars and this and that. They don't stack it themselves, but whenever they think about it in regards to like coins and bars and melt price, they're always thinking then that somehow they're gonna sell the coins to melt. Or like, I was showing someone like a gold coin a couple weeks ago. They're like, well, yeah, I mean, like, if you could sell this and they'll melt it down. It's like, why would you melt it down? It's valuable in that form. It's valuable in coin form. It's not really used industrially all that much. Silver might be, but silver is good as an investment as well. It's good for money. You could store your wealth in it. I don't see what this obsession is with melting stuff down. But unless you're trying to make poured bars and stuff. But, you know, I like it in coin form. I like it in bar form. I like it in pyramid form as well. So, yeah, there's a lot of ignorance out there. Let's try to proselytize. I'm hoping I'm saying that right. The word about silver, because it's important. You know, like, we want our fellow human beings to do well, and also to hedge their bets, hedge their wealth. You know, we want things to be okay. I think precious metals is a sound part of anybody's investment portfolio, and so much more than that as well. This isn't investment advice, but this is kind of conventional wisdom. You know, you don't want to be ignorant about the world around you. You want to know everything that you can and see how it ties into your life so that you don't make the same mistakes that people made in the past before you. Because most likely, if you're about to, you know, act with something according to the market, you know, like you're seeing some sort of trend, or you're just doing something that everybody else is doing and you don't want to miss out, more likely than not, that's happened before in the past for thousands of years. It's kind of like Bitcoin as it relates to the tulip mania. I might make a video about that in the future. So yeah, let's not be ignorant. Let's try to get our facts straight. And we're not children either. We're not babies. We're not nescient. If we don't know things, and then we're just ignorant. It's okay. I'm ignorant about a lot of stuff, but I try to really try to get my facts on point as far as pertinent information goes. So yeah, let's try to stay ahead of the curve in terms of information so we can make the best choices possible. Anyway, this is your friend, Stacker Sargentius. I'll come back to you guys soon. I hope you have a great night, and stay tuned. Peace.